Hi, I'm Nina from Pessler, and today I want to give you a quick introduction into our new app server that we will release with PRTG version 73. We've been hard at work at building a new API and a new web UI, which will give you a whole new way to access and manage PRTG. With PRTG version 21.473, we have released an alpha version for you to try out. Today I'm going to show you how to activate it, and we'll also show you some of its new features. Before we start, I want to make you aware of two things. This is an alpha version and it is not feature complete yet. There are a lot of things in PRTG that you can't do with it yet. Please also be aware that during this alpha phase, we might still make some changes to the existing endpoints based on feedback that we will receive from you. Now let me take a moment to tell you how to activate the new API and new UI. They are being run through a new service called PRTG Application Server. Once you activate the new API and UI, PRTG will start this new service automatically after reboot. You can then use both the classic and the new UI and API side by side. The new UI and API will be available under different ports. You can deactivate it anytime. Let me show you how this works. So first, I will log in. Then I will navigate to System Setup. And as you can see in the lower right corner, we have the option to activate new UI and new API alpha. I will click Activate. I will have to read through the disclaimer. I have to confirm that I read it. I'll press OK. And now we have to wait for the system to reboot. So after your browser restarted, you enter your credentials again and log into what we now call the classical PRTG view. As you can see, now we have the option on the top right corner to switch to our new UI, which I will do now. And this is our welcome page. As you can see, the new web UI consists of cards, and in general, at the homepage, you will see disclaimers where you can share your feedback or how also to get in touch with our support. Now I want to show you what is the new monitoring page. By clicking on monitoring, you will be navigated to what we used to know as the device tree. So this is the device tree you're used to. But what is new is the filter bar up here. As you can see, it has the different sensor states and also a search bar. So for example, I can use the search bar to look for my root, or I could also look for my net app and it will take me directly there. A cool new feature I want to show you is how easy it is to now filter by sensor states. So I will click on the down state and it will give me an overview over all sensors that are in a down state. They are sorted by parent devices, so it's easy for you to, for example, pause our VMware group. Another new feature is the sensors list. So as I still have the warning, the error filter selected, I'll take that out now just to show you what the sensors list looks like. So as all my sensor states are in color again, I now know that I have no filter pre-selected. And the sensors list is basically a list view over all your sensors. I will again select all error sensors, and I want to show you another new feature, and that is the possibility to apply the same action to multiple sensors at once. And I can do this by selecting the check mark. And I could now either acknowledge these alarms, I could pause the sensors, or if they were already paused, I could resume them. Going back to our homepage, this is where you also find resources on what our new UI includes, and also the mobile web interface. What does this mean? Of course, the new UI is also available on your cell phone, and it will give you the exact same information that you would have on your web UI. In case you need any technical support, you can either click on the support card in our new web UI, or you can open up a ticket with our technical support. They are always happy to help you. Another thing I want to mention at the end is that we are releasing this alpha in such an unfinished state right now because we want and need your feedback to decide on how to develop it further. To give us feedback, you can use the Share Your Feedback card in your overview homepage, or what we will also do is release surveys. You can answer these surveys to help us decide on the next features we will develop. That is all for now, so have fun trying out our alpha features, and you can also find all necessary links in the video description. Have a great time testing and see you in our next update.